各位香港市民，各位傳媒朋友，去年二月在台灣發生一宗令很多香港市民感到震驚和傷心的殺人案，一名香港少女被殺，疑犯陳同佳逃了回來香港。這一宗案件令到受害人的父母傷心欲絕，同時亦都突顯了香港在刑事互助和逃犯移交制度上的明顯漏洞。這個漏洞即是說，因為現在法例中的地理限制，我們是不能夠移交疑犯到台灣，亦都是包括鄰近的內地和澳門，亦都沒有可行的安排可以跟大約170個國家和地區，這些沒有簽訂長期協議的國家進行逃犯的移交。作為負責任的政府，我認為我們是需要盡力去找出這個方法，一方面可以處理台灣殺人案，令到公義得以彰顯，還死者一個公道，給死者父母一個交代；另一方面盡力完善香港的法制，確保香港不會成為犯罪者逃避刑責的地方。這個正正是特區政府提出修訂逃犯條例和刑事事宜相互法律協助條例建議的兩個初心。經過仔細的研究相關法律和其他地方的做法之後，修例的工作在今年二月正式在香港社會展開。我們建議的是基於現有的法例，將當中有關人權的保障和制度的保障，包括法庭的角色和香港公平公正的司法制度完全保留。相關的同事一直都和社會各界和立法會就修例的建議作出理性的討論，聆聽意見，而考慮到現時因為其他罪名在監獄服刑的台灣殺人案疑犯即將獲釋，我們希望爭取在今個立法年度，亦即是七月暑假休會前通過條例草案。事實上，我們在聆聽社會的意見之後，先後對於建議作出了兩次的修訂，一次在法案正式提交立法會之前，我們剔除了九個可以移交罪類，以及將移交罪行的最高刑罰由原本的一年以上改為三年以上。而另一次的修訂是在法案提交了給立法會之後，我們將三年以上改為七年或以上，並採納了多項與國際標準一致、加強人權保障的措施，以釋除社會疑慮，爭取更多的支持。我和相關的官員已經盡了最大的努力，但是必須承認，我們在解說、溝通方面的工作的確有所不足。雖然不少市民都認同修例的兩個初心，但是社會上對於條例草案出現極為分歧的意見，有支持，有反對，而且立場鮮明。而很多市民對於條例草案仍然是有擔心、疑慮和不理解，亦對於修例工作的過程產生猜忌。我們曾經努力去縮窄這些分歧，希望能夠消除到疑慮。過去一個禮拜，我們看到數以萬計的市民參與遊行和集會，而在星期日遊行後的午夜和星期三在金鐘一帶的示威活動中，更加出現了嚴重的衝突，導致多名警察、傳媒同工和一般市民受傷。我和市民大眾都感到痛心。出現這個情況，同樣作為一個負責任的政府，我們一方面要維護法紀，但同時要審時度勢，保障香港最大的福祉。這個最大的福祉是包括令社會盡快回復平靜，以及避免再有執法人員和市民受到傷害。 我在這裡感謝很多建制派的議員和社會各界的領袖，在最近幾日都公開或者私底下向我表示，認為我們應該停一停，想一想，不應該按住原定的計劃在立法會恢復條例的二讀辯論，避免對社會造成更大的衝擊。事實上，考慮到台灣方面已多次公開清楚地表示，他們絕不會接受在特區政府建議的安排下要求移交陳同佳，這一條條例草案在今個立法年度通過的迫切性或許已經不復存在。經過過去兩日政府內部的反覆研究，我在這裡宣布特區政府決定暫緩修例工作，重新與社會各界溝通，做更多的解說，聽更多不同的意見。我想強調，政府是以開放的態度全面聆聽社會對於條例草案的意見。保安局局長今日會致函立法會主席，收回就條例草案恢復二讀辯論的預告。換句話說，立法會大會就著處理條例草案的工作會暫停，直至我們完成溝通、解說和聆聽意見為止。我們無意就這些工作設下時限，並且承諾會在整合意見之後向立法會保安事務委員會匯報和徵詢議員的意見，然後才會決定下一步的工作。我希望在這裡感謝一直支持我們修例的建制派議員和市民，亦都感謝雖然未能夠支持條例草案，但是一直以和平理性方式表達意見的市民和團體。香港這個文明、自由、開放、多元的社會，正正是需要這一種互相尊重、和而不同的精神。最後，作為特區的行政長官，我想說，我們進行修例的初心是出自我和我的管治團隊對於香港的熱愛和對於香港人的關心，但是由於我們工作上的不足和種種原因，令到這兩年來相對平靜的香港社會再次出現很大的矛盾和紛爭，令很多市民感到失望和痛心，我感到十分難過和遺憾。我們會以最有誠意、最謙卑的態度接受批評，加以改進，繼續與市民同行。Fellow citizens and members of the media, in February last year, a murder case in Taiwan shocked and saddened many Hong Kong people. A young Hong Kong lady was killed, and the suspect fled back to Hong Kong. The case caused deep sorrow to the victim's parents, while at the same time revealed a clear loophole in our regime with respect to mutual legal assistance on criminal matters and the surrender of fugitive offenders. The deficiencies in our regime include, first, with a geographical restriction in the current law, it is not possible to transfer a suspect to Taiwan or our neighboring mainland and Macau. Secondly, there is no workable arrangement for the surrender of fugitive offenders with some 170 jurisdictions which have not entered into a long-term agreement with Hong Kong. As a responsible government, I feel obliged to find a way to deal with the Taiwan murder case so that justice can be done for the deceased, her parents, and society, while at the same time address the deficiencies in our system so that Hong Kong will not become a place for criminals to evade legal responsibility. These are the two original purposes of the government in putting forward the legislative proposal to amend the Fugitive Offenders Ordinance and the Mutual Legal Assistance in Criminal Matters Ordinance. After careful examination of the relevant laws and the practices of other jurisdictions, the legislative amendment exercise started in Hong Kong in February this year. Our proposal is based on the existing legislation, with the relevant human rights safeguards and procedural safeguards, including the role of the court and the fair and impartial judicial system of Hong Kong being fully maintained. Relevant colleagues have been discussing with various sectors of the community in a rational manner and listening to their views on our legislative proposal. As the suspect in the Taiwan case who has been in jail on other charges may be released soon, we have been trying to get the bill passed within the current legislative year, that is, before the Legislative Council summer recess in July this year. As a matter of fact, after listening to the views of society, we have introduced amendments to our proposal on two occasions. The first occasion was before the introduction of the bill, when we took out 9 categories of offences from the list of offences subject to surrender and lifted the threshold for punishment of the offences from imprisonment for more than 1 year to more than 3 years. The second occasion was after the introduction of the bill in the Legislative Council, when we increased the threshold from more than 3 years to not less than 7 years, as well as introduced a number of additional human rights safeguards that are in line with international standards. The amendments were made to ease the concerns of society while securing more support for the bill. My relevant colleagues and I have made our best efforts, but I have to admit that our explanation and communication work has not been sufficient or effective. Although many people agreed with our 2 original proposals, there are still polarized opinions on the bill. There are supporting views and opposing ones, and their stances are very often polarized. Furthermore, many members of the public still have concerns and doubts about the bill. Some find it difficult to understand why the urgency and are unhappy with the process of the amendments. We have made many attempts to narrow differences and eliminate doubts. In the last week, tens of thousands of people took part in protests and gatherings. Serious conflicts broke out in the early hours on Monday after the public procession last Sunday and during the protest in the Admiralty area on Wednesday, resulting in a number of police officers, media workers, and other members of the public being injured. I am saddened by this, as are other citizens. As a responsible government, we have to maintain law and order on the one hand and evaluate the situation for the greatest interest of Hong Kong, including restoring calmness in society as soon as possible and avoiding any more injuries to law enforcement officers and citizens. I'm grateful for the views of many pro-establishment legislators and leaders of various community sectors conveyed to me over the last few days, either openly or in private, that we should pause and think instead of resuming the second reading debate on the bill at the Legislative Council as scheduled. This would prevent dealing a further blow to society. In fact, in consideration of the overt and clear expression by Taiwan repeatedly that it would not accede to the suggested arrangement of the Hong Kong Special Administrative Region government in the transfer of the concerned suspect, the original urgency to pass the bill in this legislative year is perhaps no longer there. After our repeated internal deliberations over the last 2 days, I now announce that the government has decided to suspend the legislative amendment exercise, restart our communication with all sectors of society, do more explanation work, and listen to different views of society. I want to stress that the government is adopting an open mind to heed comprehensively different views in society towards the bill. The Secretary for Security will send a letter to the Legislative Council President to withdraw the notice of resumption of a second reading debate on the bill. In other words, the Council will halt its work in relation to the bill until our work in communication, explanation, and listening to opinions is completed. We have no intention to set a deadline for this work and promise to report to and consult members of the Legislative Council panel on security before we decide on the next step forward. I would like to thank all the pro-establishment legislators and members of the public for their support all along for our legislative exercise, as well as the people and organizations that have expressed their views in a peaceful and rational manner, even if they do not support the bill. As a free, open, and pluralistic society, Hong Kong needs such a spirit of mutual respect and harmony in diversity. Lastly, as the Chief Executive of the Hong Kong Special Administrative Region, I want to stress that the original purposes of the exercise stems from my and my team's passion for Hong Kong and our empathy for Hong Kong people. I feel deep sorrow and regret that the deficiencies in our work and various other factors have stirred up substantial controversies and dispute in society following the relatively calm periods of the past 2 years, disappointing many people. We will adopt the most sincere and humble attitude to accept criticisms and make improvements so that we can continue to connect with the people of Hong Kong. Thank you very much.
現在是提問時間，請希望提問的記者先舉手。揀到你提問的時候，請你先介紹自己和你的傳媒機構。因為今天記者比較多，請大家提問盡量簡短，和希望盡量避免提多過一條問題。明報。
林太你好，我明報何婉儀。其實2003年23條立法的時候，政府是說會撤回啦，同埋無限期擱置嘅。咁民陣同埋民主派咧，其實而家都話唔接受呢個暫緩。其實你覺得咁樣暫緩係咪可以平息到民憤咧？係咪為所謂嘅管治威信而死撐咧？第二個問題就係咧，你上台嘅時候咧話首要任務係修補社會撕裂啦，又都講過話主流民意咧令你無法繼續做特首嘅話咧，你咧就會辭職。咁你覺得係咪而家嘅情況都唔足以令你下台？最後咧就係、是、其實你成日都提到啦，你作為一個母親啦，咁其實好多香港嘅父母咧呢幾日都好痛心，好多嘅示威者同埋年輕人咧被警方以不合比例嘅武力去對待，打到頭破血流。想問其實特首你會唔會代表警方向示威者道歉啦？同埋會唔會成立一個獨立嘅委員會去檢討追究責任？最後會唔會收埋收起呢個暴動嘅定性咧？唔該。
我諗阿晨要請記者唔好即係一次過問三四條題目，如果唔係咧，就其他嘅傳媒朋友冇機會咧可以提問。雖然我今日都係希望預咗足夠嘅時間。但今天的記者實在非常多，亦都反映這件事是受到關注。第一呢，就是正如我剛才所說，我們今次修例的初心我仍然是認為是正確。事實上社會上呢是有不少的市民，包括立法會超過半數的議員呢，都是支持這個修例的工作。所以初心不變，但是工作做得不足，我們是應該給自己、給社會有一個機會，讓我們以一個更加開放的態度來到去溝通、解釋、聽意見。聽意見是用開放和全面，換句話說，我們不同的意見我們都會聽，只要大家都有共同的目標，是可以達至原本的初心。當然現在我剛才都承認兩個初心之一的台灣的殺人事件，我們或許未必做得到。所以三日前我的訪問，我都公開跟受害者的父母說，我們盡了力，但可能未必能夠做到。但是第二個初心對於香港是非常重要的，我們現在在刑事互助的方面是有缺陷，在逃犯移交裡面其實只能夠做到20個地方。所以在堅持這個初心的時候，我不覺得在現階段是可以就這樣撤回 這條條例，否則令到社會收到的訊息就話條條例根本係冇立足之地，所以你而家要收翻。咁呢個係我哋嗰個取態啦。冇錯，我喺競選以至上任咧，由於當時個社會嘅情況啦，咁我都好努力，亦都承諾咗盡量咧係修補社會嘅撕裂，希望能夠更加和諧共融。所以最後嗰段我講話，過去兩年實際上係出現咗一個相對嚇，我只能夠相對，因為喺香港呢個社會好難有嘢咧係絕對，係相對平靜。我哋亦都做到嘢，我哋唔係冇處理過爭議性嘅事，一地兩檢都好有爭議性，我哋都處理到。咁所以我都覺得好遺憾同埋好可惜，亦都好難過。即係依次嘅事件咧，係令到本嚟已經平復咗、平靜咗，似乎冇咁撕裂。嘅社會咧又出現咗一次好大嘅矛盾啊！咁但係我哋會繼續喺呢度努力啊。至於你提到喺星期三金鐘一帶發生嘅事件咧，我諗絕大部分嘅香港市民咧都可以喺新聞嘅報導特別係電視有影像嘅報導睇到咧，係發生咗有啲唔係一個所謂和平嘅表達意見。是用了一些都有殺傷力的武器呢是襲擊警務的人員、所以警務人員的執法是理所當然是天公地義是他們每一位加入香港警方香港警務處他們的使命來的你今天不能夠要求因為行政長官自己工作做得不好就連這些執法人員努力維持治安的工作都要被抹黑我做不到、但至於在現場究竟怎樣去處理一個在電光火石之間可能生命受到威脅或者帶來更大的難以可以控制到的場面一定是要交給執法的人員是不可以由其他的人當然他們不是隨便執法每一位警務人員在什麼情形之下可以採取什麼行動我知道警務處是有指引給他們也都有足夠的訓練給他們、所以我覺得警務人員是以個克制負責任，亦都係盡量可以維持到個大局嗰、那個態度咧，係嚟到工作。
商台，
係林太，商台陳業輝，想問一下，其實之前咧，其實都已經有好多意見咧，都話即係希望撤回或者暫緩今次嘅修例啦。咁到現時，其實即係反對派都會叫呢個修例做惡法啦。咁而支持者都有啲就話，即係覺得今次政府推銷手法都叫做係差劣啦。咁甚至即係覺得政府將一件好事變咗做一句變咗做一件壞事啦。咁同埋都見到就釀成一個流血嘅衝突。咁其實你覺得即係呢個衝突，其實政府？是否可以早些暫緩就可以避免呢第二就是、你覺得在這個爭議當中你和問責團隊有沒有需要問責下台呢還有都想問就是作出這個決定這個暫緩的決定之前呢有沒有跟中央的領導人有過一個溝通呢中央是怎樣評價你的修例工作呢還有、就是、有沒有覺得
我聽不到了已經
給機會
有沒有覺得這個爭議、就是、都拖累到中央呢謝謝
我真的記不到咁多，我盡量回答啦，好嘛嚇？請大家都即係簡單啲，我可以答多啲唔同類型嘅題目。第一咧就係、撤回同埋暫緩嘅考慮，我頭先講咗啦嚇。呢件工作係如果套用你嘅説話咧係好事。事實上，我覺得喺國際社會都會認為呢件係好事，因為我哋做嘅刑事嘅互助，顧名思義係一個互助。即係話香港特區政府同其他嘅司法管轄區嘅有關當局互相幫助嚟到打擊嚴重罪行，咁所以呢個係完全站得住腳嘅立法嘅初心嚇。咁所以亦都係點解我哋暫緩咗，希望能夠咧係進一步可以溝通啊，或者係聽意見啊，再改善。第二點，你講話有人話我哋手法唔好，咁我認嘅，我頭先已經承認，亦都唔係今日先第一次。講啦，喺幾日前嘅電視嘅訪問咧，我都係話我哋嘅工作係做得不足嚇，我哋嘅溝通係唔知點解係冇效嘅嚇。但最終出現咗社會咁嚴重嘅矛盾咧，亦都有其他嘅原因嚇。我頭先喺個開場發言都係咁樣講。咁所以有冇空間，有冇機會將原本嘅好事辦翻好咧？我希望有， 我哋會盡最大嘅努力咧嚟到去做。所以呢個時候係應該係講做翻好事嘅時候，係講我哋點樣能夠去同市民溝通，讓佢哋明白我哋嘅初心，亦都俾翻我哋有呢個嘅即係空間，亦都可以挽回對於特區政府嘅信心。因為我哋除咗呢個修例工作，我哋有排山倒海經濟民生嘅工作要處理啊。至於中央嗰個角色咧，我哋都公開講過啦。呢個工作修例嘅工作係由香港特別行政區政府主動自發去做，整個過程都係由特區政府去主導啊。但係中央一如既往對於特區同埋我本人佢哋嘅立場都係咁嘅。第一咧，理解香港嘅情況同內地嘅情況好唔同啊。呢個亦都係兩制嘅差異啦。理解香港其實真係好事辦好咧，都唔容易嚇，係複雜嘅。第二咧就係信任特區政府同埋我本人，因為我哋喺最前線，我哋先睇到而家發生啲咩事，嗰個情緒去到咩嘅程度。第三咧就係尊重呢一份嚟自中央對我嘅尊重咧，喺呢兩年嚟真係時常都深刻體會嚇。因為很多事情真的為什麼會這樣呢，就要他尊重我，我真的認為是這樣。最後就是支持，所以中央在整個過程裡面都是採取理解、信任、尊重、支持。在我們第二次作出改善的時候，有部分的措施是直接涉及中央的，因為這條條例其實是講緊其他所有的司法管轄區，不過就係拎走咗個地理限制，讓內地、台灣、澳門都好似其他百幾個司法管轄區咧可以做個案嘅移交。所以本來你可以話我唔使問中央部委嘅喎，都即係大家都係咁做。但係因為喺討論過程，大家聚焦，我可以理解嘅，大家聚焦都係喺內地。咁所以去到第二次嘅加強嘅版啦嚇嘅修訂咧，起碼有兩個係好直接中央嘅。第一咧就話香港特區政府只會處理由最高人民檢察院提出的移交申請，我不能夠憑空講，我說你都不會相信，你一定會跟著問中央有沒有同意你這樣講話，這個是問過中央，中央也是支持。第二個的加強的措施就是當移交了的逃犯在內地被判刑了，今天我們跟內地是沒有判了刑在囚的人士可以回來香港坐牢這個安排的，為了保障加強保障這些香港人在移交之後的福利，我們都聽到意見說喂，你不如跟中央說可不可以香港人如果是因為移交逃犯判了刑可以回來香港服刑，也都是要中央同意。所以起碼這兩個很特定的涉及中央內地制度的請求咧，係具體咁得到中央嘅同意。
再次提醒大家，希望大家問問題嘅時候盡量簡短一啲，同埋唔好最多最多問兩條。The gentleman over there, yes, BBC, please. Use the mic, please. Use the mic, please.
Can you use the microphone? I can't hear.
Wait your turn, please, Matt. Sorry
I see,
that.
Is that gentleman?
Yes. You want to sit down? Okay.
Yes.
I'll stay seated.
It's the BBC.
Mrs. Lam, I'm from the BBC. Is this really, as you suggest, about a misunderstanding? Are so many Hong Kong citizens really that easily confused? Or is this more about a problem that the people of Hong Kong deeply distrust the central government in Beijing, and many of them see your government as not really representing them, but representing the interests of the central government in Beijing? Thank you.
Well, first of all, as you will notice, I have not used that term, misunderstanding. I was saying that we have not done sufficiently to explain and allay fears and concerns and so on. Okay. Of course, it is difficult for me as a chief executive standing here to evaluate the causes of that resistance or fear or concern about this bill. But I would confess, as I did in a statement on Wednesday, I said that in the past years or so, we have seen this sort of situation where there's major confrontation, and very often the issue that has given rise to that confrontation has a mainland dimension. Okay? And I'm sure you can name a few. I can name a few. Nah. But no matter what, when there is that concern, that fear, I think everyone should be given an opportunity to increase their confidence, to allay their concerns, so that if it is a good thing for Hong Kong, then we get it done. This is exactly what happened to the co-location legislation last year. We have a high-speed train, 26 kilometers, that is ready to go. But in order to achieve the effectiveness of a high-speed train in that sort of circumstances, we need co-location of the mainland and Hong Kong CIQ facilities. But that would necessitate mainland law enforcement bodies to operate on Hong Kong territory. So we went through a very elaborate process, a three-stage elaborate process, to allay the original concerns and fears about that sort of situation where mainland officers could come down to Hong Kong to enforce the law. So you could say that I originally also harbored that sort of wish, that through intensive discussion and explanation and legal safeguards, we could overcome that concern and get this good thing done, because the purpose and intent of a legislative amendment has been accepted by many people, I'm sure by BBC, because you are very international. You must have been reporting on a lot of anti-money laundering, anti-terrorist financing. So that sort of legal assistance on a mutual basis between jurisdictions is extremely important. On your second question about the position of the chief executive, again, if people have a perception about the chief executive's institution, not Carrie Lam herself, but the institution of the chief executive, that he or she, being appointed by the Central People's Government, will only obey the orders of the Central People's Government. And that, if that is a view, then that is a view that does not sit well with the basic law. That's not aligned with the constitutional role of the chief executive. Under the basic law, the chief executive has due accountability. She or he is responsible to the Central People's Government, but at the same time, responsible to the people of Hong Kong. And what is more important, that is in the basic law, every act of every person, including the government, the chief executive, has to be lawful. So even if your boss, even in any sort of situation, in a private enterprise, if your boss who pays your salary asks you to do something unlawful, you shouldn't do it. You wouldn't do it, right? So I hope that explains the relationship between the chief executive and the Central People's Government. And I have been adhering faithfully to that constitutional characteristics of this position of the chief executive. Thank you.
先等一下 Alfrey。
Mrs. Lam, RTHK English News. After all the intense and some would say unprecedented opposition and conflicts we've seen over the past week because of the extradition bill initiated by your government, do you think that you're still fit to govern the city as the chief executive? And will any government officials take the responsibility for this crisis and resign from their position? And secondly, hundreds of thousands of people took to the street asking your administration to withdraw the bill unconditionally. Do you really think that simply by suspending the bill, the people of Hong Kong could be pacified? And do you think that suspending the bill will help restore people's confidence in the government?
Well, about the first point, as I have repeatedly said, and I hope people will appreciate, in doing this legislative exercise, myself and my colleagues were driven by our passion for Hong Kong. We want Hong Kong to do well. If Hong Kong's justice system and mutual legal assistance regime have some major deficiencies, it is our responsibility to rectify those deficiencies so that Hong Kong could do better when another situation arises. It is also driven by our empathy for the people of Hong Kong.
We could easily ignore Mr. and Mrs. Poon. We said sorry. We are very sorry about the death of your girl. But we have empathy for them. We just ask ourselves, if the situation happens to my son, John Lee's child, what would we do? This is what I call empathy. We have empathy for the people of Hong Kong. And this is not the only occasion as a chief executive that I displayed very strongly that empathy for individual people of Hong Kong. So with that objectives in mind, yes, we have not done a good enough job to convince people and to ensure that this laudable objectives could be met. But give us another chance. We will not only do this bill well, if we, in our engagement of people, we can get more diverse opinions, we can build broader consensus to do it, we'll do it. But we have other things to do. We have the economy to look after, we have livelihood issues to address. On the former, especially, we are expecting some downturn in Hong Kong's economy. That's where we will continue to perform and deliver for the people of Hong Kong. Now, the decision I made today is not as described as pacifying people. Or some people said restoring some of my damaged reputation. That's not the purpose. That the purpose is very simple. People of Hong Kong want a relatively calm and peaceful environment. And we did have that relatively calm and peaceful environment in the last 2 years since I took office. Yeah. So this is a time after what you describe as this tension, conflicts, and so on. This is a time for a responsible government, having looked at the situation and the circumstances, to restore as quickly as possible that calmness in society. That is my first consideration. The second consideration is in any confrontations that I have seen on Wednesday, it is very possible that when it recurs again, there will be even more serious confrontations. The 80 or so injuries, very minor, generally minor injuries that we have seen, may be replaced by very serious injuries to my police colleagues and to ordinary citizens, whether they are very fierce protesters or just ordinary students joining a protest. I don't want any of that injuries to happen. So those are my two considerations in announcing that we will pause and think and for the time being suspend and halt the legislative making process. Thank you very much.
Cable.
林太你好，有線陳偉恩。首先想問翻咧，其實台灣嗰方面咧，一早就已經講咗佢哋唔會接受用逃犯條例修訂咗之後呢個方式去移交陳同佳翻去。外國亦都即係多個國家發出咗個聲明質疑呢條修例，而市民喺6月9日嘅時候已經好多人出嚟，係無論你話103,000定係200,000已經出咗嚟啦。咁但係點解去到今日你先話要？暫緩條修例咧，即係你唔係今日先知道，其實大家對呢條修例都好有意見啦。係咪因為有消息講到韓正落咗嚟，即係同你有個溝通啦，所以中央出咗聲，你先決定要暫緩修例，係咪你呢個先係不負責任嘅做法咧？因為你一早已經知道台灣方面係唔會用呢條條例去接收陳同佳噶啦。第二條就係、是。
唔該，我諗差唔多。係
第二條，
答咗先啦。
第二條你話兩條嘛，第一條係個解釋嚟嘅。好。咁第二條就係你話會再溝通噶嘛。咁但係而家啲法律界人士或者係啲員出嚟，佢哋講咗個問題就係因為唔能夠接受內地嘅司法制度問題，並唔係因為溝通解説不足嘅問題。因為林太你同司局局長已經係即係密集式解説咗好耐，我諗你自己都即係知道大家溝通咗好多啦。點解覺得溝通係可以解決到內地嘅法制問題咧？會唔會係你到今時今日都未見到？呢條修例嘅問題喺邊一度咧？但係最後就係好簡單，你會唔會收翻定性暴動？市民係暴動，因為頭先你提到係唔完全和平嘅示威，同埋你同你嘅政府團隊會唔會問責下台？唔該。
嗱，我即係提我話講句啦嚇，喺呢啲咁嘅場合，喺任何嘅場合都係互相尊重。既然有個遊戲規則話最多兩條，咁啊喝極你都係要第三條，就唔係尊重個遊戲規則啦嚇。
請大家請大家靜啲，請大家靜啲，請大家，
我請大家靜啲啦，
請大家靜啲。Please, please, please。 請大家靜啲，請大家靜。
我以為我回應咗㗎啦，喺前線嘅警務同事處理，同埋佢點樣去即係形容定性咧？呢、這個都係警務處嘅責任。我係贊成，亦都係同意呢種嘅講法嚇。我喺個星期三嘅聲明都講咗啦。呢、這個係行政長官係好清晰嘅講法嚇。第三條集咗啦，所以第一條係有關於，因為其實第一條都有三個法嘅，即係台灣國際或者係本地嘅社會係喺過去呢一段時間咧係發表咗啲意見，但大家要明咧，整個係一個過程。我如果每一次聽到一個意見、兩個意見、三個意見咧，就可以大幅度改動政府嘅政策咧，呢、這個都唔係一個即係適當或者負責任嘅做法。咁所以係去到我哋喺過去一禮拜。我哋睇到個形勢咧，係開始進入去令人擔憂，亦都令人痛心，所以又出現咗我頭先講嗰兩個理由，必須要盡快回復社會嘅平靜，必須要防止再有執法人員同埋市民因為雙方意見嘅分歧或者對立咧而受到傷害。至於喺我哋對進一步嘅溝通嗰度咧。其實如果認真去睇唔同嘅團體，特別係兩個律師會啦，即係大律師公會同埋香港律師會咧，又唔係所有嘢唔做得嘅啊，即係唔係話總之你唔好做呢樣嘢啦，因為一做呢樣嘢涉及內地咧係冇得做，好似唔係咁，係有啲可以做嘅方法嘅嚇、啊。不過當時咧，我哋對於呢啲方法有啲睇法。但係進一步其他嘅方法可唔可以研究咧？當然可以研究啦，特別喺律師公會好長嗰份嘅好厚嘅發出嘅聲明裏邊咧，個內容我哋都起碼我本人都未可以仔細研究，因為個時間就係每日都發生得好快呢啲事。咁所以我覺得再溝通，而且係以一個開放嘅態度溝通，即係我冇前設咯，我唔係逼你要接受而家呢一套。我哋要開放嘅態度去溝通，聽唔同嘅意見，然後先係諗下一步係點樣樣，都係一個合適合理嘅做法啦。
再次懇請大家簡短同埋問唔好多兩條，我希望盡量俾多啲人問。後邊係咪 TVB？
你好啊，無線嘅盧怡。兩條問題，第一條問題咧就係頭先都承認啦，過去兩年嘅社會其實係平靜，但係就而家啦出現翻撕裂啦同埋矛盾。我想問你點樣去修補翻啲撕裂，同埋你會唔會就住過去咁多市民同埋警察因為上次嘅衝突事件受傷，你會唔會同香港市民道歉？第二條，既然係你之前曾經講過話修例去彰顯公義，去堵塞漏洞，咁而家你打算點樣去處理翻台灣殺人案？你點樣同潘生潘太交代點樣彰顯公義咧？唔該。
第一咧就係過去兩年大家係睇得到社會係相對。比較平靜，我不想利用這個的說法呢來為我的班子去做一個評價、這個留給大家，即為何社會突然會平靜 就由大家自己去判斷啦、但總之似乎大家都同意過去兩年是相 相對比較平靜、但以後怎樣可以盡快可以回復平靜，如果我認為過去兩年平靜是因為我哋多處理行政立法關係，更加即係展示個誠意，多透過實際嘅政策嘅工作而得到，咁我哋咪循住呢個方向繼續去做啦。至於我哋點樣定性我哋自己處理呢件事，頭先我講咗啦。呢個修例嘅初心咧，係我仍然堅持係好嘅，係應該做嘅。但是在過程裏面我們做得不好，出了一個現在這個後果，我們會補救，我們繼續呢就用最大的時間、耐性、誠意來到跟市民去溝通，希望做好這個工作。其他我們在經濟、創科、民生、房屋、土地的工作呢，我們會繼續很努力地做。至於台灣的個案，我剛才都應該答了，不過再說一次了，就我們一直都很想做，當我們找到一個方法 認為可以做的時候呢，我和我的同事，包括保安局裏面的同事和律政司的同事呢，都感到安慰，因為起碼我找到。因為我可以告訴大家，另一個做法就是當件事或者個要求一提出的時候，我們看看本法律書，沒有法律基礎就答，就答回潘生潘太，很抱歉，很遺憾，沒有法律基礎，沒得做。但我們沒有，我們答了潘生很多次信，有些我親自答，沒有一次告訴他剛才那番說話，因為那番說話我覺得可能對他更加傷害。我們盡最大的努力，今天盡了最大的努力，但是都是沒有辦法可以做得到。那我們都是只能夠跟潘生潘太說，我們真的盡了努力，希望你能夠釋懷，知道特區政府是做了很大的努力。事實上今天即使在七月前過到的法例，結局可能是一樣，因為剛才我都轉述，台灣已經是多次公開清楚表明是不會用你的方法來申請移交，所以都是或者做了都未必有一個令受害人家長滿意的結局。
Gentlemen there, CNN?
Hi, Matt Rivers with CNN. The question I have for you is what took so long? Given that you knew what public opinion was after the protest last Sunday, why did you wait so long to come to this decision? And are you nervous about the march plan for tomorrow? Thank you.
No, our decision has nothing to do with what may happen tomorrow. You mean tomorrow. We have nothing to do with what may happen tomorrow. As I answer in another question, it has nothing to do with an intention, a wish to pacify. Why take so long, actually? If you remember what I said in my account, I acknowledge that last Sunday, we had a large number of people coming out. It's very peaceful. It's generally orderly. So this is part of Hong Kong.We do have that sort of protest from time to time. But it is on Wednesday that that sort of polarization views in society relating to this bill has given rise to violence, very serious confrontations, people being hurt, police on the ground sort of being forced to take some of those measures. That's why I come to the view, I told myself,that I need to do something decisively to address two issues. How could I restore as far as possible the calm in society? And how could I avoid any more law enforcement officers and ordinary citizens being injured? So that was Wednesday to Saturday. Meanwhile, I met with people because, as you know, in this sort of circumstances, you have only one shot.So I need to ask my advisors. I need to think through. Our team has to deliberate it within ourselves. And this is my earliest opportunity. Although it is a Saturday, I did not wait until Monday to explain to you the deliberations leading to this decision. And so I hope you understand.
The lady there, Reuters.
So, what details did you give in the emergency meeting with Han Zheng in Shenzhen, and what did you tell him? And can you explain why you didn't withdraw the bill, but instead you suspend the bill? And also, why don't you step down now? Thanks.
Well, first of all, I could not comment on any meetings I have with anybody if it is not a public meeting. The chief executive has her own schedule.Every day. So I cannot confirm to you whether I have met a particular person during that day. If it is not an official meeting that needs to be announced or publicized. But if you are interested in the Central People's Government's position and whether they have been informed about my decision, the answer is yes. Since all along, they have taken such an understanding, supportive approach towards this local exercise.Which is entirely within Hong Kong's autonomy to do. I feel obliged to report to them that I have now considered all factors, and I wish to announce today that we are making a change. We are suspending the legislative work in order to allow more time for communications, explanation, listening of opinions, and then decide on the way forward. And I can tell you that the Central People's Government adopts the same attitude. They understand, they have confidence in my judgment, and they support me. Okay. As far as the difference between suspension and withdrawal, I have answered a few times, but in very brief terms, it's because this legislative exercise has very well intended objectives. One is to deal with the Taiwan case. The other is to rectify the deficiencies in our current regime to deal with mutual legal assistance on criminal matters, and also to allow surrender of fugitive offenders with over 100, was actually about 170 other countries and territories without long-term agreement. I hope nobody disputes those two objectives. So with those two objectives in mind, withdrawing the bill seems to suggest that even those two objectives were erroneous in the first place, and I cannot accept that, because I think they are the needed objectives. And if I may just elaborate a bit, especially for the international audience, to rectify the deficiencies in our regime is something that we have always been asked by the international community to do. One of these international organizations is the Financial Action Task Force on Anti-Money Laundering, comprising the G7 countries, based in Paris. Hong Kong is a member in the name of China, Hong Kong. We are a member amongst, I think, 37 members of this group, the FATF. The FATF came to look at our situation. It said that by and large, we are doing well on various aspects. But there is this aspect which we ranked very low. It's because you have no extradition arrangement, no mutual legal assistance on criminal matters with mainland Macau and Taiwan. So they said, you better do it as a matter of priority. So that was on our agenda. Anyway, we have to do something. So at least now I said, I made an attempt. I would tell the FATF next time they came, I have made an attempt, but somehow we could not deliver it yet. Well, we will try it again if circumstances permit. So the difference between suspension and withdrawal could be explained in that context. As far as myself and my team, we will continue to work very diligently and hopefully to achieve the same effect that we have seen since the 1st of July 2017. That generally society is more peaceful, there's less tension, people are focusing on the economy and livelihood matters. Although I would say that even on livelihood matters, especially housing, we have not been doing the best that we could to meet people's aspirations, but we'll continue to work very hard.當時都是這樣做，亦都有法案委員會，法案委員會主席都是非建制派的議員。 都係可以喺嗰個過程裏邊，佢哋再提一啲人權保障，政府接受，結果條例通過，被視為係一個有用嘅藍本啊。建制派議員咧就其實由始至終都好堅持支持我哋嘅嚇。不過喺建制派議員裏邊有一啲商界嘅背景嚇，因為佢哋種種嘅原因，佢覺得條例可能對佢有啲影響，令佢有擔憂，所以我哋咪同佢另外喺一啲商界嘅商會嗰度傾。咁啊，考慮咗佢哋嘅意見或者其他專業團體嘅意見，就先後作咗兩次嘅修訂，嚟到去啊釋除嘅疑慮同埋加強保障啦。其實而家建制派嘅問題反而係我哋點樣可以令到佢哋喺以後更加早啲掌握到政府制定政策嚇，就喺好早佢哋可以已經將我頭先講話喺我哋。即係局長提出之後，佢先話唔係喎，我哋代表商界咧有啲咁嘅意見，咁所以以後係可以更加提早，即係有一啲叫醖釀啊嘅工作咧係可以做嘅。至於我哋跟住我個班子嘅工作，頭先都係講咗好多次啦。我哋繼續努力我哋嘅工作，因為而家香港社會正正係需要做事嘅人，無論喺應對經濟下行嘅風險。或者係滿足到市民喺房屋方面嘅需求，人口老齡化方面嘅挑戰，醫療嗰個嘅壓力咧，都需要有一個能辦事嘅班子咧，為社會做實事。
Please， 因為其實仲有好多記者想問，不如我建議大家問一條咯嘛，我希望盡量俾多啲記者問，好冇？呢位副醫生。
係特首，我有幾條問題想問嘅。
一條唔該。
O K， 但係包括有啲剛才你冇正面回應啦。咁例如就係剛才有提到，就係其實今次中央的確正如你所講，好尊重你啦。外交部、中聯辦、港澳辦多次撐你。咁但係最後呢個禮拜，即係又經過民意表達之後，你要到今日先至有呢個決定啦。你會唔會覺得其實你係香港撕裂嘅始作俑者？你今次事件有冇為中央添煩添亂？第二條咧就係今次正如你所講啦，有啲建第二條咯，第二條咯，依家係第二條啦。
你
建制派一直你正如你所講都係啲忠實嘅支持者，到尋日都有人係一直幫緊你去撐修例嘅。但係你今次而家呢個決定，你會唔會令到佢哋好似覺得俾你玩咗一鑊？你之後會用啲咩措施去安撫佢哋？以後你嘅施政仲可以點樣做咧？
中央對於特區政府今次主動自發去做呢份工作咧，正如我所講，係支持嚇，係支持嚇。所以因為呢件係政府特區政府內部嘅事咧，我哋都係話得，我哋聽到支持嚇。我需要具體嘅支持咧，我再會同中央提出。咁所以去到第二輪嘅即係改善嘅措施咧，頭先已經解釋咗俾大家啦。起碼有兩個特別嘅安排係需要中央。原則上默許我才能夠以一個更有權威 的方法講給大家聽，那中央都是支持的、為什麼你會覺得有中央好像講了很多話呢？其實真的是沒多久，當我們二月中去做這件工作，沒多久就已經有其他的外國政府很多的評論，那你大家都明白，外國政府會評論中華人民共和國香港特別行政區的內部事務，中央透過外交部發言人作一個回應，或者到後期，即係外國政府嘅評論介入越嚟越深度，越嚟越即係氣温上升嘅時候咧，咁啊中央都係要話翻俾佢聽啊，我哋中央都係好支持呢個工作，而事實上呢個支持咧亦都係理所當然嘅，因為講緊係去彰顯法治、改善司法嘅制度，咁對中央嚟講咧就係支持。咁而家支持一直支持埋我今日講嘅嘢。我剛才都透露了中央都是同樣支持。至於建制派沒錯，我
請你不
要打斷，我講了支持就不是添煩添亂，即有些我不可能你逐個字我逐個答的，各位記者支持，當你去支持一個人，你就不會說這個人是你那四個字啦，是不是就建制派呢，我相信你們現在去訪問緊，我完全接受建制派議員如果認為是有些失望，有些失望，或者令到他們、對他們自己的支持者交代有困難，我完全接受，也是我剛才已經率先 同所有，不唔係所有出席啦，同幾十位建制派議員咧去交代呢件事，亦都希望得到佢哋嘅理解同埋包容，因為大家嘅共同目標都係唔想香港亂，都唔係想香港出現一啲再嚴重撕裂啊，甚至有一啲暴力嘅情況，影響到我哋嘅警務人員或者係普通嘅市民。咁所以即係但對於呢個過程裏邊，佢哋作為我哋最堅強嘅後盾，我係深表感謝嚇。我頭先喺發言嗰度咧，都係有感謝到建制派議員同埋支持者喺呢度再次對於佢哋喺呢幾個月嘅堅實嘅支持，甚至係喺地區嘅層面不顧被人侮辱、抹黑，咁樣去堅定支持特區政府咧，我再次表示感謝。
請大家再盡量簡短一啲。Now TV。
Now TV 李卓軒想問咧，其實過去四個月，大部分嘅人都反對過三次遊行，遊行過，專業界別都發過聲明反對，點解要去到星期三發生大規模衝突，你先肯收回？係咪以後有爭議性嘅問題，你都要逼市民上街，甚至有衝突，或者甚至流埋血，你先會？可能考慮一下暫緩。同埋另外想問，頭先有英文媒體問過你有冇見韓正，你係話以唔係公開會面而唔講，你可唔可以正面答你有冇見過韓正？係咪因為韓正叫你停手你先停？因為張建宗接受我哋訪問星期四都係話唔會收回條例嘅。究竟星期四接受訪問完之後，今日你同中央中間發生過啲乜嘢事，令到你要收回？同埋你會唔會？
我諗差唔多啦，
叫局長問責下台，因為推唔到呢條法例。
我答咗第二題目先啦，第一條都唔係好記得嚇。就正如我所講，行政長官每日有好多日程，見好多人，係唔可能將我所有嘅見人見邊個去講俾大家聽嚇。全世界都唔會，我相信嚇。咁所以咧冇辦法可以直接回應嚇。如果呢個令你不滿，我都冇辦法，因為呢樣嘢如果係隨意破格破例咁回應咗咧，就對後日後不但止我啲管治團隊個個要將佢啲私人日程俾曬大家睇咧，個影響就好深遠。呢個決定係我做嘅。如果要知道呢個決定係我做咧，其實都唔係好簡好複雜嘅啫。事實上我頭先講咗啦，過去兩日嗱星期三。跟住星期四、星期五嗰兩日，我見到大量嘅人，亦都有唔少嘅社會嘅領袖嚟見我嚇，或者用其他嘅方法去話俾我聽，佢哋都希望我哋停一停、諗一諗。我係基於呢啲同埋我剛才講嘅兩大嘅考慮咧，作咗呢個決定。作咗呢個決定咧，亦都係通知中央。中央考慮咗我嘅判斷，一如既往咧都係尊重同埋支持。這個很清晰了，希望不會再有任何的揣測，是一個中央的命令，等於最初做這個逃犯條例不是一個中央的指示做。兩三日前，即使我國駐英的大使劉曉明大使跟我說怎麼樣，這件事是特區自發想改善法制做的，中央沒有給過指示，這個是清晰無誤的了。希望至於在過去由二月中到現在是一個過程來的，事實上到今天我都只能夠說意見分歧，很難說一面倒是只有一個意見，如果是只有一個意見就建制派都反對，那可能更加容易處理，但意見是分歧，分歧的立場都很鮮明，即似乎又大家都不是很肯走多一步來找一下妥協的空間。所以我都是看了過去一個禮拜發生的事，基於我剛才兩個考慮，希望社會早日回復一個相對的平靜，這個不是只是因為禮拜三是相對的平靜，也都希望不要出現到進一步的即有人的受傷害，所以作出了這個決定。這個決定是艱難的，因為今天作出了這個決定就在短期內是似乎難以可以實現到這個初心去改善到香港的法制，但是我都希望社會給時間給機會我們再去努力在這方面的工作。
The lady here please。
Bishop Vaughan Robbins, Sky News.
Please.
Hi. This bill has spread fear and sparked some of the worst
violent protests on this city street since the handover. Are you going to apologize to the people for the damage that you and this bill has caused?
I have repeatedly said in my opening statement and also in response to some questions that this bill has very laudable objectives, not only domestically but also internationally. The enactment of this bill will help to raise Hong Kong's international profile and also demonstrate that we are a place with excellent rule of law, not only for our own citizens, but also in contribution to the combating of serious crime on a cross-border and transnational basis. Okay? So with that very laudable objectives to do, I confess that we have not been as effective as we would like to communicate with the people to justify this very good objectives that is worth doing. And at the same time, there are other factors and other circumstances that have given rise to some anxiety and fear and concern. So the best way forward is to pause and think and to find opportunities and time to see whether we could still reach that good objective as laid down in the bill. So that is the approach that I have taken.
Yeah. Hi, Hatu. Is it the lady at the back? Yes. Okay.
Thank you very much, Chief Executive. Raimi Innocencio from CBS News in America. Where we were in the protests on Wednesday, we saw excessive police force being used. Someone right next to our team was actually hit in the head. It seemed that police were actually targeting protesters in the head and in the torso. Or organizers for tomorrow's protest have been calling for you to say that they are not rioters and that they want the people who have been arrested to be released. Will you do this?
Hong Kong is a very lawful society. I have just mentioned in response to another question that even as a chief executive, I have to act lawfully. So I cannot sort of override the law enforcement bodies to decide who should be arrested, who should be released. That is totally unlawful. And if I were to do this, I don't think many people or investors will continue to trust Hong Kong, because the CE could do anything, could see you to arrest somebody and detain somebody or release somebody. So no way, I'm not going to interfere into the investigations by the law enforcement bodies and also the prosecution and also the judicial proceedings. Everything has to be done lawfully, especially for prosecution and judiciary decisions. They are independently discharged as provided for under the basic law. So as a chief executive, I cannot breach the law, let alone the basic law, which is such an important constitutional document. Your reference to the use of force, I think everybody who watched the TV news on that day will notice that the police were doing defensive protection of the Legislative Council building and so on and so on. But what you have been told by the Commissioner of Police is some, I wouldn't say all, definitely not all, because talking about 40,000 people maybe, some of the protesters were quite violent. And if you have looked at some of the weapons that the police had seized, they were not sort of equipment that one would deploy in a peaceful protest or a peaceful assembly on a social issue. And have you looked at the bricks? Large numbers of bricks throwing at the police. Yeah. Have you looked at some of the cars deliberately being placed in the middle of a road to obstruct traffic? Did you know that one of my principal officials was sort of detained for several hours on the road because of the blockade? So I hope that you can take everything into consideration before you come to a conclusion of what was the incident on Wednesday.
前面綠色衫，
想請問林太，你會唔會承諾本屆立法會會期唔再提出恢復二讀？另外，作為公僕，你認為點解 咁多人反對、咁多人上街嘅時候，同埋發生咗流血衝突之後，你有理由唔下台？
第一咧，這個而家暫緩咗之後咧，係要作一個全面嘅去聽意見嚇。尤其是我話係用一個開放嘅態度嚇。我剛才一發言亦都話咧，我無意為呢個聽意見嘅工作咧係設一個限期。咁所以咧就既然冇限期，亦都唔可以承諾。不過我而家可以同大家講咧，因為我擺咗另一個嘅叫做關卡啦，即係我唔會就咁翻去立法會大會作一個恢復二讀辯論。我哋聽完意見，整合咗啲意見咧，一定會先交翻俾立法會嘅保安事務委員會啊。咁所以並不存在即刻又俾個預告咧，可以翻去立法會恢復二讀辯論。而按住我哋嘅經驗啊，我本人都經驗豐富啊，喺政府裏邊要做呢啲又全面又多聽意見又多解説。而家已經係六月中啦，我睇嚟咧喺今年內。我哋都難以可以行到第一步，即係話翻去立法會嘅保安事務委員會。即係如果嗰個時間性對你係嘅疑問係有用咧，我俾呢個嘅時間性咧，就係睇嚟喺年底之前咧都好難做完啲工作係可以翻到立法會嘅保安事務委員會咧嚟到去作一個嘅綜合嘅匯報。冇錯，我係一個接近40年嘅公僕，我仍然以做公僕為榮。而且我係好大量嘅工作想為香港做啊，無論喺拓展經濟、改善民生嗰方面，咁我希望咧繼續喺呢一方面咧係以我40年嘅公僕嘅經驗咧，能夠為香港可以開創一個更美好嘅未來。
仲有兩條，呢位另一。
香港另一鄭文德，林太，我想問一下咧，今日有報道指話，今次政府高層判斷啦，星期三嗰場衝突係外國策動嘅顏色革命。咁其實呢一個消息講咗出嚟之後，有好多批評都覺得政府呢個講法係諉過於人。我想請問特首，你而家仲覺唔覺得呢場仲係一場顏色革命，定還是其實係港府一路喺推行修例嘅過程入面誤判形勢，所以先至搞到咁多人上街同埋衝擊立法會咧？唔該。
一個簡單回答就係我哋冇作過呢個判斷。
港台，
俾台灣問啦！
台灣的，台灣的事。
港台，
這是台灣的事嘛？
你讓他問，
請你靜一啲用 ，please。
沒問您問。
好，其實沒有殺傷力的問題。
請問，
好。我是台湾中视的记者，那想请问一下，刚你的说法是不是陈同佳案就没有办法再去做？因为香港政府从案发到现在一直没有直接跟台湾的相关单位有过沟通，到了今年二月份之后，你们才表示会透过策划会、差进会那些来沟通。那未来会不会有直接的沟通去解决这个问题？
香港特别行政区跟台湾的沟通一向是透过两个这个组织，一个是策进会，一个是协进会啊。我们在台北现在还有一个经济文化的这个办事处啊，但是按照这件事情台湾当局是有几次希望我们提供协作，形式的协作，也希望我们往后能移交这个陈同佳。这个也是驱动我们找一个法律的基础，找一个方法来做。但是我们是花了一段很长的时间才能找到今天这个方案啊。但是现在看来，这个方案也没可能在这个陈同佳离开监狱以前能做到。所以我现在的说法就是，我们应该是没有这个法律基础跟这个台湾。来这个按照他的要求就把这个逃犯移交。感谢，
谢谢大家。